Introduction to the Oscilloscope, Part B. We are going to look at how to display two different signals. Connect one cable to channel 1. Connect the other end of it to the output of one of the function generators. Connect the other cable to channel 2 and connect its other end to the output of the other function generator. Turn on the oscilloscope and wait for it to boot up. Press the default setup button. Turn on the function generator that's connected to channel 1. Adjust the function generator to somewhere between 300 to 500 Hz. Set the voltage at about halfway. Adjust the voltage and time settings until there are a few waves displayed on the screen and the displayed signal is less than half a screen in height. Using the ground adjust, move the signal to the upper half of the screen on the oscilloscope. Push the number 2 button on the second channel to turn it on. It's displayed as a straight line right now because the second function generator has not been turned on. Turn on the second function generator. Set the frequency on this function generator also between 300 to 500 Hz. Almost, but not exactly, the frequency of the other signal. Notice that the second signal is not static. It's being triggered at the rate of the first signal, which is not its frequency, so it keeps getting drawn different each time. Lower the second signal to the bottom half of the screen. If I want to see both signals stable on this scope, I can hit the Run Stop button. This stops both signals. Notice that if I push it several times, the bottom wave doesn't always stop in the same location. Press the measure button. The frequency and peak-to-peak voltage for channel 1 will be displayed on the screen. With this button here, you can change to channel 2, and then you can select first of all frequency, and then add measurement, and you see frequency for channel 2 has appeared. And then I can look for peak-to-peak voltage. I have to press it a lot of times to get there. Then press Add Measurement. And now I have the same two measures for both channel 1 and channel 2. Let me push the Run Stop button one more time and make it go again. If I want to make channel 2 stable, I can push the trigger button, select Source 2, and then the bottom one is stable, but the top one is not static. Next, we will use the Math Menu button. When I press the button, it adds the two signals together. Now, they are not the same number of volts per division, so I have to adjust it to match the other two signals. I do it with the top one of these two knobs, and I turn it until it's at 5 volts per division. Like this, it seems to have an odd behavior. But watch what happens when I increase the time sweep. What you are looking at is something called the beat frequency. You see this when you have two frequencies that are very close to each other in value that are added together. If these were sound waves, they would sound like wow, wow, wow. The frequency that you hear is the average of the two frequencies, and the frequency of the beat is the difference between the two frequencies. As I adjust one of the frequencies closer to the other, I make the beat longer. Listening for the beat frequency is the best way to tune guitars and pianos. Now turn the math function off. Now we'll change how we're using the horizontal axis by pressing the horizontal axis menu. After we press it, we come down here and we select XY. Now one of the function generators is being graphed on the X-axis, and the other function generator is being graphed on the y-axis. I can adjust where on the screen the figure is by adjusting the ground adjust knobs under the voltage per division knobs. Adjust one of the function generators, trying to get the frequency of that function generator the same as the other function generator. Eventually, you'll get an interesting figure at this. You'll get an oval or a circle in this case. These frequencies have a 1-to-1 ratio to each other. Try other ratios like 1-to-2 or 2-to-3, and you'll see some other interesting figures.